So what I'm up now, I'm up to now is to translate a small basic into assembly directly. So it becomes a language that has the properties of a high language and a low language at the same time. Also, you have this small basic program that is made in basic and it's made to count. Also, wait, this is a program. The program, what it does is just count. It starts with bobbin 0, it adds 1, it compares with 1 million, and if it's not 1 million, restarts. And like that. And every time it goes, it reaches 1 million, resets, and Alice gets one more. So you see, it just counts. It counts, but it counts. A million, it's a million, you see. It hasn't reached the first million. Now we count it to 1 million. Let's see how long it is. 2 million. So you see, it counts fast. It counts faster than a person, but it's not really fast. But what I did was build a translator that is very basic. Just has three variables with names Alice, Bob, and Eve. And the comparison if afterwards just can go a logical jump. It can be anything else. You can print, you cannot call, you just can go to. Just like assembly, because it's a direct translation with assembly. It may seem you are programming in basic, but actually you are programming in assembly using another word. So I programmed this in Ruby. No, wait, this is the. I programmed this in Ruby. And it's a program that, as you see, Bob equal to Bob plus whatever, transform it in add to AX whatever. It's quite simple. I'm gonna evolve it more, but now it's quite simple, but it's powerful enough. So you see the program. So this has an output. So I run this program. It asks me for the path to the small basic file I want to translate. So I enter the path. And it translated it to assembly. And it's a bit here. This is the ASM file. I open it. Now I open it with MASM32. Is built, and I'm. This is now assembly, but to make the executable now, I just have to press a button. You see the code translated here. The rest is always the same. This part is always the same if you use an Intel chip. So I go to project, console assembly and link. It gives no mistake, so now it built it. It built it, and now it's built into machine code directly. This is, and it's very short. It's like very efficient code. you see, it's like very short. It's a very short program. It's not like if you make it in a small basic, that in a small basic, besides the program is gonna be very big, it's gonna run through all the Microsoft APIs. This just runs through the print API. It's the only API it uses, because I want to get it complicated. I want to get it fast and simple. So the only API it uses is the print. Well, okay. So this is the executable. Counting. So are you ready now to check the speed of this basic code translated to machine code directly? Remember, it counts 1,000,000 at a time. It's the same program that before. So let's see. You see how it counts 1,000,000? It's like something amazing compared with the other. You see, let's have arrays. Counting. I'm gonna make an executable with a small basic again, and let's have arrays. Well, yeah, it's okay. Doesn't really matter. But you see the difference. Let's see again, small basic, the same program in small basic. It now reached the first 1,000,000. Now let's give it some advantage to a small basic. 2,000,000. Now let's see, identical program translated for me to machine code. You see, it's something, imagine again or whatever. Is the difference would be amazing. The problem I think that there is that every time a language is created, or an API or anything is created with high-level language which are highly inefficient. And with these highly inefficient created things are creating more high-level, high inefficiently things. So inefficiency multiplies and in the end becomes unbearable. Okay, so thank you for your attention.